Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
So the Mastiff is a great pet because they are very gentle. They are very loyal to the family members and they're very good with kids. So even though they're huge, they are gentle and they're great protectors. So they're a great family pet. My name is Clark Henderson and I've been breeding Mastiffs for about 24 years. My kennel name is Mystery Mountain Mastiffs. I live on Mystery Mountain Road, so it was pretty perfect. Although I live in the country, Mastiffs are great out here in the country, but they're also very, very good in the city and in small areas. But for me, it's really terrific to be out in the country. I run them all together and, off leash, and they enjoy it a lot. Mastiffs typically don't need a lot of exercise, but I try to get a lot of exercise for my dogs because I do think it's really good for them, for their health. But again, it's not necessary to live in the country and have a lot of space for a Mastiff. I've sold Mastiffs to people who had live in a penthouse in New York City and probably live better than you and I did. So anyway, I do enjoy being out in the country and I think the dogs really enjoy it too. I love to walk the dogs. My wife and I, that's one of our favorite things to do in the evening, is maybe have a glass of wine and take the dogs on a walk. And I do like to run them all together. I have three adult, fully intact males who are all three stud dogs, and they do get along. I make sure they get along. I'm kind of the alpha dog, so they do listen to me, and it makes it really enjoyable when we can take them all together. Now, you have to still watch them, and I don't recommend that you would have two unneutered male dogs in your household. It's just, it could be scary because they can fight, and if they fight, it's a big problem. But again, I've been training dogs for a long time, so I have the knowledge behind it, so that's what I like to do. And I also like to show that they are sweet dogs and they will get along if you teach them to get along. I've been breeding them for 24 years and showing them. I do handle my own dogs and I enjoy the dog shows. Don't want to be there every weekend, but I do enjoy it. And I think it's important whenever you're breeding a purebred dog to be showing, to make sure that you are still breeding to the standard and that you're winning. And again, keeping up with what everybody thinks is a great example of your specific dog. Well, ever since I was little, I've loved dogs. So I had Rottweiler and a Bull Mastiff when I was in high school. And I thought that someday I would, breed dogs. And I probably would have bred Bull Mastiffs. So I would have picked Bull Mastiffs. But my first wife, while we were dating, she saw a Mastiff in the back of a pickup truck and she really liked it. And so that's what I got her for our wedding present. So that's how we started with Mastiffs. So Mastiffs, there's several types of Mastiffs. They all come from basically the Molossers, which were an ancient breed of giant dog. They were called Molossers. And so they used them, the Romans used them for war dogs and things like that. And so eventually they were refined a bit, and the ones that ended up as English Mastiffs, they bred them specifically to guard castles in England. You know, they wanted a dog that was big and intimidating looking, but they also wanted a dog that was going to be friendly to the people who lived there. So most people are not going to take on a 220, 230 pound dog. They're just not even going to find out if they're a mean and nasty dog or not. And so technically they go back thousands and thousands of years, but they certainly were refined in England, you know, in the probably 1400s up through now. And they actually almost went extinct in World War II because England was having a tough time and there wasn't a lot of extra food to feed big dogs. So they almost went extinct. And it's pretty much sure that they use St. Bernards to kind of bring them back. So sometimes you have some that look a little more like a St. Bernard, but that's kind of the history of Mastiffs. So the other breeds, the modern breeds that are related to the English Mastiff would be certainly the Bull Mastiff, which they crossed the English Bulldog to the Mastiff back in the 1830s to create a Bull Mastiff. You have Italian Mastiffs, which are Neapolitan Mastiffs. You have French Mastiffs, which are Dog de Bordeaux. You have Brazilian Mastiffs, which are Fila Brasileiros. So there's also Spanish Mastiffs. So all of those are closely related to English Mastiff. Also, Great Danes, they got Great Danes from Mastiffs. St. Bernards came from Mastiffs. And again, back the other way. Mastiffs are supposed to be large. They are the largest breed of dog by weight, and there is no maximum size. There's minimum standards. So a male Mastiff has to be 30 inches at the shoulder, female has to be 27 at the shoulder, and then weights vary depending. I would say an average female is around 150 to 180, but certainly I've had females, I had a female that was 250 pounds. Males are typically 180 and above, and you know, a lot of the males are in the 220 to 240 pound range as far as the big, really nice show champions that are winning. They really do need to be big. The world record was a dog named Zorba, and he was from England, and he weighed 343 pounds. And the first time he broke the record, he weighed 315. He broke there was a 310-pound St. Bernard, and he broke that record really just being in really good shape when he was a pretty young dog. And so later on, they put some weight on him to really set that record to where it really wasn't going to be reached. I don't think there's too many dogs that have come close to it. I've actually bred a dog that weighed 300 pounds and several that are in the 280 pound range. The interesting thing about Zorba is they put that extra weight on him and then they took it back off. But he was a giant dog and he lived to be, I believe it was 13 years old, which is very impressive, very impressive. And life expectancy, unfortunately, they don't live that long. I would say a really average life expectancy is probably 8 to 10. The oldest dog I've had was 12 and a half. I was really happy with that. But the bigger they are, they usually don't live quite as long. It's just kind of like humans. They're really big humans don't live as long. So it's just kind of that way. Well, the Mastiffs are considered to, they say they're a combination of grandeur and good nature. So they're really supposed to be extremely impressive looking, but they're also supposed to be very good natured. You can't have a dog that's that size that is not good natured. You just can't have it. So they are supposed to be very sweet, very approachable. But the main, really the biggest feature on a Mastiff is the head. They're a head dog, so they have to have a very large, expressive head, which fits the standard, and that has to do with the muzzle length can't be too long, and they have to have very broad between the ears and that kind of thing. They are supposed to be very deep in body and also very wide, but they're also supposed to be able to move, so they can't be overweight, and they can't be a dog that's doesn't have any athleticism at all. So I know there's a tendency in the show ring to really push the athleticism of them, and sometimes then you lose the type. Breed type is, you know, basically he really looks like a Mastiff, whereas the ones that get athletic, some people might say they look a little more like a Great Dane. So you got to keep that combination. You got to have a dog that really looks like a Mastiff, but they also have to be healthy and be able to, you know, move and get out of their own way. The main health issues probably in the past was like hip dysplasia and things like that. And we've been pretty good as breeders to really, you know, OFA certified our dogs and make sure that that is not an issue. They can have heart issues, cardiomyopathy, not near as much as like Irish Wolfhounds, but they can have that. There was a blindness issue that came about called PRA, progressive retinal atrophy. And luckily with some really good scientific work, they isolated the gene so you can test your dog to make sure they don't have that. So it's mostly, you know, a situation where you got to keep them in decent shape. They can get overweight and that can tax the heart. So, but we also do OFA certifications of their heart. So that really helps us to make sure that they're healthy to breed, et cetera. Bloat is somewhat of an issue, not as much as a breed like a Great Dane or a Doberman or something that's a little deeper chested and narrow chested, but they do have, they have been known to bloat. In my years, I've had, I think, three or four of them that have been sold that have bloated, and usually at a later age. I would not recommend prophylactically tacking the stomach like they do with some of the breeds, like Bloodhounds and Danes, but it is a little bit of an issue. So Mastiffs do need to be socialized a lot because they can have a tendency to be shy if they're not around things and haven't been socialized, and you don't want a big dog that's shy. You don't want any dog that's shy. So they do need a lot of socialization. I live out in the country. It's a little bit more difficult for me to socialize because I'm a little more isolated, but taking them to dog shows and I take them to the Little League fields and have them around the kids and those kinds of things are really helpful. But that would be one of the top priorities of a Mastiff owner, to make sure you get the dog dog out and get it socialized as much as possible. And basic obedience too, because you really need to be able to control the dog. They listen quite well and they're not super energetic, but they're big and they're strong. And if they want to do something and they're not trained, they're going to do it. Mastiffs are pretty easy to take care of as far as grooming wise. They're short coated. They do shed, but they don't need to be brushed that often. And sometimes even just a wet towel, you can just wipe them down and they'll be pretty good. Main thing is they do tend to slobber a little bit. Not so much all the time, but when they eat, they slobber. And when they drink, they'll stick their face in their water bowl and come over and want to stick their face in your lap. So that's what Mastiffs like to do. Pete is a grand champion and he is about 6 years old. And he's a tremendous dog, great temperament. He's been a great show dog for me. He's got amazing type, great size and everything. Probably my best overall dog that I have right now, although I have some nice younger dogs that are coming up, but he's been a terrific dog. He's almost six and he's about 240. Yeah, he's about 240. And that's a good weight for him. I wouldn't want to put any more weight on him because he's pretty thick and he's not real long bodied. So he would tend to get a little bit obese if you put weight on him. He doesn't have the length of frame to put on a lot of weight. Second dog was Zeke. Zeke's a young dog and he is a champion. He is, it's kind of a neat story. My foundation sire was a dog named Champion Gropetti's Lord Henry of Mystery Mountain. And he was the son of a very famous Mastiff who was a Westminster Best of Breed winner and a group placing Mastiff in Westminster back in the 90s. And so Hank, as I call him, was about 280 pounds. And so Hank passed away in 2004. So Zeke is Hank's son and we use frozen semen to get him, and so he's the only Hank's son that's alive on the earth today, and so he's a really neat dog. He's about 215, but he still has some room to probably get maybe about 225. He's not gonna be as big as his dad, but really nice moving dog, great attitude. He's really showy, he loves to show. A lot of Mastiffs don't like to show, they just don't really wanna get out there and run around the ring, and Zeke does. He's got a lot of energy, and that's been really good for his show career. Calvin. So Calvin is Pete's nephew. So Pete's brother is a dog named Optimus Prime, and Optimus was a huge dog. He was about 280 pounds, and he's owned by my friend Tom Fisher of Prideland Mastiffs. And so Optimus, Tom and I go back and forth. We, you know, breed our dogs together. We kind of have the same program. And so Optimus produced some really nice litters, and I wanted to have an Optimus son. And Calvin's just a really sweetheart of a dog. He's not near as big as his dad, but he's got great body length. He's got a really nice head, and he's really athletic and just as sweet as could be. Calvin is almost three, and he's about 215 pounds right now. Cleo is a Calvin daughter, and she's about 18 months old, and she's I've been showing her for a little while. She likes to show and has done pretty well, and a beautiful brindle color. She's got the body length that Calvin has, and she's got some really nice angles, and she was the flower girl in my wedding. I got recently married a year ago, and she was the flower girl for our wedding, and that was really fun. So I love Mastiffs. They to me are really the epitome. It's like what the lion is to the cat, the Mastiff is to the dog. And I like that. I like the fact that they're kind of the biggest, coolest looking thing around. They do have to be big. You know, that you got to keep them big because they're supposed to be big, but they got to be sweet too. And I really enjoy breeding them. I enjoy showing them and I enjoy having them around my friends. My friends always get a kick out of coming out here. And I'll tell you what, if you want to draw a crowd, you take a Mastiff out in public because you will have everybody around will surround you. So it's kind of a neat feeling.